रहा था, ही वॉज गोइंग पास द कब्रिस्तान, ही सॉ द कब्र, या अल्लाह एक दिन मुझे भी जाना होगा इसके अंदर, वन डे आई ऑल्सो टू गो इनसाइड. He stood there, he started crying. Rona shuru. You know, in Surah Yasin, there is an ayat there. Ayyuhal mujrimun. Where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to say, all those that have committed sin on the day of Qiyam, come out from your line and stand one side. Rona, why? Today we're so afraid that our gunas will come out in the open and be ashamed. Arey tum us din ko nahi sochte ho, when Allah is going to take you out in front of the whole dunya and make you ashamed. To Allah ke samne aise khade ho. Still time. Doors of rahmat is not closed yet. Make dua to the wasila of Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Allah forgive you and make you a better person. He says that that man was being passed. He also wasn't such a good man. But he got frightened. Why? Because the cough of Allah came into him. Ya ayyuhal lazina ittaqullah. Fight for Allah. Faman kana yarju liqa'a rabbihi falyamal amala salihan. If you know that you are going to go and meet your Allah, do good in your life. Why are you doing wrong? Kanjusi kyun karte ho? Apne upar kanjusi karte ho? You're reading durood and salam for who? For Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Kya usko aapki durood ki zarurat hai? Allah need you, Allah's Nabi need your durood? No! Durood hi nahi hai. Jo Allah har waqt, every second Allah is sending durood and salam to Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Tumhare durood se kya hoga? Even when you're making dua, you're not saying, Ya Allah, I am sending the durood. You're not saying, you are sending the durood. You're making dua, say, Ya Allah, aap durood bhejo humare Nabi ko. Aap hi koi bhejo. And that dua will never be rejected. Why? Because you are saying Allah to make the dua. And Allah is saying to you that dua I am making before you was even born. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ali sayyidina Mawlana barik wa sallim. So he said, this man, he read ayats of the Quran, he stood there, O mother. He recited the durud and salam upon Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. And he gave the salam of the durood and salam to each and every one of us in this Qabristan. And through the sadqa and wasila of that durood and salam, O mother, hear carefully. Allah remove all of us that were in azab and put us to raise. Let's we all get together, my brothers. Read the durood and salam again, once again, for all our marhumin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through the sadqa and wasila of this durood and salam, that we are saying, Ya Allah, you reset to your Nabi. You sent to the Nabi, the Ali Nabi. To that durood, may Allah forgive our marhumin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them jannah to firdaus, inshaAllah ta'ala. You know, time. Allahu Akbar, time to ho gaya. Abhi shuru hua. Abhi garam hua. Ek hadith bayan kar ke khatam kar. I have one hadith. InshaAllah. You see, Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. His right name was Abdul Rahman. He was known as Abu Huraira. Abu Huraira is known as the father of cats. Abu, father, Huraira, cats. Every time Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam used to look at Abu Huraira, he used to see cats in between his sleeves, cats on top of him. And he was a beggar. Beggar meaning, not like ours, in this time. This time, the person had one month, he got food for 1 month. He said, my pir bhi gharib. But in those times, the gharib was those, if they had breakfast, they didn't know where lunch will come from. Ke milega ki nahi milega. Abu Huraira was that kind of sahabi. And you see, Abu Huraira had the dua of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. One day Nabi alayhi salatu wasallam came in Josh. You know, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam, wo to aate hai Josh mein. Allah kabhi kabhi unko ishara kar dete. You see, maang kya maangte ho? Maang, what you want? Ask me. Maango. Jisne jannat maanga, usko jannat mil gaya. जिसने पैसे मांगा उसको पैसे मिल गया, जिसने जहन मांगा उसको जहन भी मिल गया. अबू हुरैरा से या रसूल अल्लाह, एवरी टाइम आई हियर द वर्ड्स कम आउट फ्रॉम योर माउथ, वो एक कान से जाकर दूसरे कान से निकल जाते. हदीस बुखारी से बात. या रसूल अल्लाह दुआ फरमाए, And Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala says, from the time of the dua of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, till the day he closed his eyes, wallah, there was not one word that came out from Nabi alayhi salatu wa sallam that he did not know. And the proof is in the hadith. You have six hadith books, Siyah Sitta, Bukhari, Muslim, Ibn Majah, Tirmidhi, Abu Dawud. Every single hadith book, most of the hadiths that were revived in those books was not by Umar Farooq, not by Abu Bakr, not by Usman, but it was recorded by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, because he was the one that had that brain because of the dua of my Nabi Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So sahaba ne pucha, ki ey Abu Hurairah, hame ek aise hadith sunao, jo hame fayda de. And that you also thought that it was very important. Say Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala, jab ye baat suna, when he heard this, ki main kaun si hadith ko bayan karu, jo sabse zaruri hai. Wallahi, he said, he cried and he fell unconscious. Hosh aaya, say Abu Hurairah hadith, rona shuru. Phir behosh. Third time, same thing happened to him. When he woke up the fourth time, he says that hadith of Nabi Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is still there. Where it is stated that the ulama, those that have knowledge of Quran and Hadith, will be the first ones to go in Jahannam. A person will be called in front of Allah, who is an alim, a person who knows Quran and Hadith. Abu Hurairah farmate ki main bhi hoon mein, I also make the riwayat of Hadith. I am also like that. This is my hasad gonna be also like, I'll be tested like this also. Make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that what we say we must make amal. Hum bhi insaan hain. Hum se bhi galti hote hain. We also make guna. Allah must make us maaf. Make us good people. Learn from our mistakes and don't go back on the same thing. He said that alim will go. Allah will ask him, acha bolo, kya kiya tune? What you did? Allah, I gave you knowledge. I gave you ilm. What did you do for me? Mere liye kya kiya? He said, Ya Allah, I went to so many places and I made da'wat of yours. So many people have been made Muslim. Allah will say, did you not do that so people can say you're a big alim? You're a bada alim. You got too much knowledge. Say, I gave you that. The people didn't say you're a great alim. They didn't make your chacha in the world. Yes, Ya Allah. He said, what you did for merely can. Listen. Allah will tell the angels to catch him by the hair and drag him into Jahannam. The second person will be that person whom Allah had given wealth. So much of wealth. Illa mashallah. Allah, many of us take example from this. And I can tell you for sure, even while we're sitting here, there are some people that don't worry about wealth. When you don't worry about wealth, wealth will come knocking at your door. As if you won't even know. Wealth is given to you by Allah to use in Allah's way. And many people, when Allah gives them the wealth, they stand in front of Allah and say, what did you do for me? Say, Ya Allah, built so many mosques. Masjid humne banaya. So many places are made of ibadat. You see, but isn't in the front there you put your name there in the black place? Why you did this? So people can say you're a very sakhi aadmi hai, tu acha aadmi hai. Tere paas bahut paise hai, you got a lot of money, lot of wealth. You're such a good man. Your heart is so big. Main tujhe duniya mein de diya. Mujhse kya chahte? What you want from me now? Tune mere liye kya kiya? They catch it by the hand, drag you. And the third person will be that person who is a shaheed. Like, the three categories I'm talking about is the highest form of categories you can get. In the eyes of Allah, that person is more great who has more ibadat in them, who has more knowledge in them, and who gives their life for Allah. Shaheed, same story. Say, why you give your life? Did you not give your life so people can say you're a big shaheed? You're a martyr. People are talking about you. Maine to duniya mein de diya, tujhe mere liye kya kiya? No answer. Allah will say to the angels, catch him by the hair, drag him into. So my brothers in Islam, my point from this whole thing is, we are nothing. And until we realize that, you won't go anywhere. Only Allah and His Rasul is the greatest. Love Allah's Nabi, Allah will love you automatically. And whatever you do, do it for the sake of Allah and His Rasul Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And the advice I have for you from this whole thing is read Durood and Salam for yourself. For Allah's name that is taken, that dua will never be rejected. Your namaz can be rejected. Your roza can be rejected. Your hajj, your going for hajj can be rejected. But that Durood and Salam where you are saying that, Ya Allah, you make dua for my Nabi. You make dua for my Nabi's arm. That dua will never be rejected. And that person who does that, Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Jisne ek dafa durood pada, Allah uspe upar 10 rahmat farma. Allah gives him 10 rahmat. The more durood you read, the more Allah will give you barakat, rahmat. He'll take you away from all the gunas and all the problems that you have in your life. May Allah give us the hidayah to do that and to do good. فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُوا لِكَاءَ رَبِّهِ That person who has in his heart that he wants to meet Allah, جائے to Allah سے ملے گا فَلْيَعْمَلْ صَوْلِحَ Do good deeds in your life. For Allah will accept it and Allah will put you into Jannah of Firdaus. May Allah give us the hidayah of that and give us true love and muhabbat for Nabi Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and make us better Muslims for the future. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَى الْبَلَادُ مُبِينَ جِزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرٌ